Okay guys, today we have a CBR1000 Repsol edition. We have a problem with this bike. When we start the bike, there is a small knocking sound, but when we ride the bike, once you turn in into third gear, there is a huge knocking sound coming from the engine. This is your third gear. So my suspect, we have a problem with his gearbox. But anyway, we'll go through the disassembling of this engine and we'll check one by one of the parts. We're gonna check the clutch, we're gonna check the tension and everything else before we really tear down the engine. So first, before we doing all the disassembly, I would like you guys to listen to the noise. So we're gonna start the bike.
Oh my god! Wow!
Wait, kita kena tolak. Look like the starter is heavy, might have a problem. First gear, second gear, this is your third gear. Woo. Listen that. On the fourth gear, nothing. Fifth gear, nothing. On the sixth gear, also nothing. This thing only happened on the third gear. Okay, this one. So let's open up the engine. Sometimes, you know, the bikes indicates you with the engine light. You have problem with your sensors, you have problem with your engines. So the bike give an indication of engine light popping up from your dashboard. But if you feel irritated, you just block it with a tape.
What?
Amazing. This is a very genius solution.
Nice.
Already taken off all the power set, everything. So now we're gonna open up the clutch before we really tear down the engine. The first thing we're gonna see if the clutch is in good condition, if there is any damage to the clutch or not. If it not, then it is confirmed the gearbox. But again, the best is look into your clutch just to double confirm, making sure that you don't do a silly decision. Honda is commonly known to have this kind of problem when you are using QuickShifter. QuickShifter is a tool that we attach to the bike so that we can change the gear without pulling up the clutch lever. So it's basically an electronic devices that we attach to the bike where we cut off the ignition or cut off the fueling. So when you have when your ignition is cut off, so basically there is no load in your gearbox which allow you to change to the next gear. For a bike which is putting an aftermarket quick shifter, I will suggest them not to use a quick shifter when your bike is running lower than 4 or 5,000 RPM. It's the best to use it higher than 6,000 RPM. The clutch assembly looks normal though, honestly. The clutch looks okay. There is no broken clutch plate, detached item or pieces on the clutch. Everything looks intact. Everything looks okay. Now we're gonna continue taking off all the parts on the clutch. Yeah, it is the gearbox though. So, as we suspected, see, that is basically your gearbox tooth. And it's broken. So now we're gonna continue digging down this engine and we're gonna check every single tooth on the gearbox, what can be used, what need to be replaced. So from there we can decide. So this is the gearbox which is broken on the secondary shaft. Let's see if there is any broken tooth on the primary shaft. Okay, so if you look on the input shaft as well, there is a marking of a broken tooth. So this is the broken tooth. So we already recovered it from the engine, which is this one. Three broken tooths on the secondary gearbox shaft. So the primary shaft is not broken completely, but it's been kind of chipped off. Alright, so this is the one. You can see that it's chipped off. On the end there, on the first fork looks okay. Second fork also looks okay. On the third fork as well looks okay. So if the fork is okay and we have a broken tooth, pretty much it is caused by the quick shifter. Right now we have the parts teared down for the CBR1000, so we're gonna start with the assembly or reinstalling everything. But before that, I would like to show you the gears that we retrieved from the bike. So this is how the gears look like. And after discussing with the owner, so we have decided to use a second-hand, a good condition gearbox set, which is value to money is much better than, changing each gears. So we get this about $400. And we're going to install this, the whole set, to the bike. Because why? Although this gear, if you look, it's only damaged on the third gear. We have this damage. And if you look on the input shaft as well, it's damaged here. But if you look through, you will see that the gears on the first gear is also damaged here, right? So we have gone through, we have found out that most, like 3 or 4 gears are also damaged. By calculating the amount of gears, that's probably going to cost the owner about 3 or 4 thousand ringgit, which is about $600. So we have decided just to buy one set of a second-hand one, which is more economical. So we're going to replace the set, we're going to install it, and once we install it, let's see if the noise is still there or we manage to make the engine running much smoother. As we noticed when I tried to start the bike, we're going to start the bike. We find out that the motor was too heavy. When we crank the engine, we notice as well the meter just blank off. If you look, I tried to turn the starter and it's really, really, you know, it's heavy. Let's crank it without any load and see is it okay or not. Okay. It's really heavy. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna open up and see if we can fix it. If not, then we have to basically change the motor as well. The starter brush looks okay though. There is no damage, it's not broken. And let's see the other side. Looks okay. That's why if you look, that's why we don't have a crank. You see, where is this magnet located now? This magnet suppose attached to the housing, then only it can turn this motor. It is attached to the motor starter itself, so that's why it's stuck. So what we can do is we can try to attach it back, put a glue, clean it first, we clean it and then we attach with the glue, and then install it back and see if it works, and let's hope we can fix it. Okay guys, so we finally has assembled the engine. So the engine is ready and it's already attached to the bike. The only thing that we have not installed is the radiator. What we're gonna do is we're gonna test the bike. We already put in oil, engine oil, everything. So now we want to start the bike. Remember, we have an issue with the starter where we cannot crank it and start the bike. This is due to the starter was bad. So we have already installed, replaced the starter and installed a new starter on it. So next, what we need to check, after we start the bike, we want to ensure first if there is a knocking sound still coming from the engine while it's on stage, means it's on idle. Second, when we put the third gear in, if we still have the knocking sound from the engine. So let's start the bike first, see if it's still okay. The gear, first gear, second gear, this is the first gear, second gear, the third gear, fourth, fifth, and sixth. And this is the third gear. Tutup belakang. Man, listen to the engine, man. Smooth like butter. Seriously, there's nothing more complicated. Like, you know, you have to mold the engine or you have to mold the gearbox. This is so easy, like. I hope you learned something from this video. Alright, don't forget to like, share and comment. Subscribe. Subscribe. When you subscribe this channel, it will grow bigger. It will make me happy. When I'm happy, I will make more video. Then you will get more knowledge. Alright? So, as I said, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoy with the video. There is a says in Malaysia. How liao miao miao chio chio. Mantap babu. Abang sayang korang. It's mean. Good job, son. Ciao. Assalamualaikum.